In the last couple of weeks, we have talked about many of the different environments in the Mediterranean Sea, but we have also discussed some of the issues that the Mediterranean and the other seas around the world are struggling with. So this week, we're gonna give you a bit of an outlook of what might be the things to come. Well, we have pointed out quite a few of the actual issues already. This time we're gonna pin it down to a few very designated ones that every single marine body in the world is struggling with. So here we go. Coastal development might be one of the biggest issues for our oceans. We do build marinas, we do build harbor walls, we do build massive structures along the entire coastlines everywhere around the world. And by doing so, we unfortunately also damage or sometimes even destroy entire ecosystems. We talked about the coastline before and we learned that it is a system that is full of life if you look close enough. But also outside the actual constructions, there's usually quite a bit of sediment and dust and other stuff coming into the sea that just kills off entire ecosystems. In the Mediterranean, this would mostly affect seagrass meadows like Posidonia that we talked about as well. But there's also coral reefs in the tropics and many others around the world. So coastal development is definitely one of the big issues. Chemical contamination of sediments and biota caused by pollution from urbanization, industry, antifoulance and atmospheric transport. Although environmental conditions are improving in regard of certain pollutants in many Mediterranean areas, thanks to improved control of land-based pollution releases, contamination linked to hazardous substances remains a big problem in many areas. Eutrophication caused by human-mediated input of nutrients into marine waters is a source of concern, especially in coastal areas and near large rivers and cities. Impacts of eutrophication include algal blooms, some of them harmful, and hypoxia. The direct socioeconomic impacts are related to toxicity or mortality of harvested fish and shellfish, loss of aesthetic value of coastal ecosystems, and reduced water quality impacting tourism. One of the prime examples of eutrophication this year was, for example, the Marmara Sea near Istanbul. The impact of marine litter, concentrated especially in bays and shallow areas, is increasingly regarded as a matter of concern across the Mediterranean. And while the world is talking about the five gyres in the big oceans, the Mediterranean in some circles is already considered the sixth gyre of this world, with plastic concentrations higher than in many other places around the globe. The impact of marine noise on biota, especially marine mammals and fish, requires targeted research. Intense maritime traffic, particularly in the Western Mediterranean, and intense offshore exploration and military activities in specific locations suggest potentially serious impact. With shipping traffic being more and more on the rise, of course the noise increases as well. So, at some point we should come up with a decent solution on how to keep the noise level underwater a little bit lower. Invasive non-indigenous species have increased in recent years, particularly in the easternmost reaches of the Mediterranean. Documented impacts on natural diversity include predation, alteration of the food web, niche competition, and modification of habitats, leading to a variety of impacts on fishing, aquaculture, shipping, human health, and tourism. Overexploitation beyond sustainable limits affect many of the commercially exploited fish stock of the Mediterranean. The result is changes in species diversity, with some species regarded as endangered, vulnerable, or near threatened. Overexploitation also leads to changes in community structures, the food web, and, ultimately, ecological processes and the delivery of ecosystem services. Other pressures brought by in the intense fishing activity in the Mediterranean include by catch, non-selective fishing methods, and destructive fishing. Understanding how multiple pressures reduce sustainable limits of harvest is necessary for effective fisheries management, which is crucial in a part of the world where seafood is both culturally and economically vital. And finally, the state of biodiversity reflects the cumulative effects of pressures affecting the Mediterranean coastal and marine environment. Although there is still high diversity in the Mediterranean, some species of reptiles, marine mammals, birds and fish are reaching dangerously low abundance levels. The Mediterranean also holds a diverse array of habitats of commercial, ecological and cultural importance. Many are under a variety of pressures. Complicating the issue, many offshore areas where upwellings develop and seamounts provide important habitats are located beyond national jurisdiction. So the real question is, where does all this leave us? There's certain things that we can do something about, and there's others that are basically out of our hands. For coastal development, yes, there will be more constructions going on in the next years, and probably the next decades to come, simply because the demand is there. We need more ports, bigger ports, more marinas, more place for boats to put them, more discharge areas for oil tankers, for cargo ships that bring all the stuff that we want from everywhere around the world, all over the place. So all this will happen, to an extent. If the demand goes down a little bit, the building speed will at least decrease. Chemical contamination is a tricky one, as well, a good part of it is the same as eutrophication, it comes from land. So that's a matter of cleaning up our mess on land, and that's something we can do every day basically by looking for sustainable farms that don't put tons of chemicals in the ground to make the crop grow faster, to cut down on pollution altogether. That starts with plastics, which I know is an inconvenient subject because it's simply everywhere. It's near impossible to not use any plastic. But there's many things that we can avoid, and especially when it comes to toxins, basically by not using them, we're doing something good for ourselves as well, since they are never ever a good thing for our body either. Same is true for marine litter. Everything that ends up on the road eventually finds its way into the sea. Now, the biggest contributor to marine plastics, microplastics that is, by the way, is from car tires. So next time you sit in your car, doesn't matter if it's an electric car or fossil fuel powered, every car has tires, and the tires, as we all know, they do wear down. So all this rubber that we're using off from the tires, which is only annoying every couple of years when we have to buy new ones, but all this is microplastics that does find its way into the sea. The overexploitation, on the other hand, is something that has always been ongoing, or ever since we had the means to become efficient enough to overexploit. Now, fishing fleets are still growing, the methods that they're using are still getting better and better, so that is an ongoing subject. And the only thing that we can do about it, really, is to keep the demand down. That means cut down on fish consumption. I know, again, inconvenient, because we're basically telling people what to eat and what not to eat, not telling anyone not to eat any fish, but for the ecosystem, it's best if you go low on the food chain. For the ocean, really, going low on the food chain also means that the nets that they will be using are finer mesh. That again means there's a lot more bycatch. The bycatch generally dies in the process as well, and then just gets discarded again. So there's a very fine line to keep an eye on right there. But ultimately, every decision that we make, every choice that we make in the supermarket when we go shopping, does have an effect on the long run. While we are still hoping for politics to change and all the big regulations to be more suitable for the planet that we're living on, well, knowing politicians a little bit now, I'd say that will take too long. So really, it's our call to make the right decisions. And all of this, especially the fisheries, also cuts into the biodiversity. So of course there is invasive species that find their way into the Mediterranean, and they find their way in many places around the world. There's really not much we can do about them. I know by now there's whole hunting rodeos going on in places like Cyprus, for example, or in the Caribbean for lionfish, where hundreds and thousands of them are caught in a single day. It is, to an extent, slowing down the process, but it's really not the ultimate solution. So for this real solution, well, the smartest thing would have been to not get the invasive species in the first place, which in the case of sewers would mean building a couple of locks, and that would basically stop the flow that is constantly coming in. But on the other hand, it also means if we want to keep the biodiversity high as it is right now, we have to stop abusing the system. So there's nothing wrong with going for a swim, going for a dive, boating. It, like, all the use of the marine ecosystem is perfectly fine, but to an extent. And right now we are overexploiting this entire system, and we're taking too many resources, we're overfishing the system. Like, on average, we say that every marine food web has already lost one trophic level, which means if you have a food chain with, let's say, 5 links, at least one of them is already gone. And that's a global issue. So bottom line is, and to cut it really short, we have to make a couple of not exactly convenient choices. And we have to cut down on our convenience, and we have to cut down on our consumption and on our use of many things. But there will be more videos in the future talking about all of this in more detail. For now, I hope you have learned something, and, well, stay tuned, there will always be more to come. If you want to learn more about any of these particular issues that we discuss in this episode, please do have a look back in this playlist. There are dedicated videos for pretty much everything that was mentioned. Alright, that's it from me for this time. See you around, and hope you enjoyed. Bye-bye.